great honor for me to stand here this afternoon. There are many aspects of pulse virus infection. At this moment, I want to focus on the pulse virus persistence, and I'm going to talk about the each gene signatures based on single-cell RNA sequencing result. In antipulse virus response, the viremia is a preeminent feature of initial acute infection. And generally, it is disappeared within a few weeks, but the pulse virus can persist in the infected pigs for more than a month. This figure clearly shows that trend, especially the bile load shown in the lymphoid tissues during the persistent status. So we can define persistence during the first infection as the period between the clearance of virus from the blood and the extinction in the host. The persistence period can transmit the infection to the naive pigs, and it is hard to detect or to diagnose it from the blood samples. In addition, the mechanism of the persistence of pulse virus in the host is still not unclear. So recently, the Dr. Fang's lab established the in vitro models of pulse virus persistence using Mark-145 cells. And they found that the pulse persistence cell line contains three subpopulations of cells. The left side figure showed that in acute infection status, there are only two types of cells, with a blue cell indicate that non-infected cell. And then other infected cell show the blue and green and red one. That means this virus is expressing the both viral double-stranded RNA and proteins. But in persistent infection status, another types of infected cells were found. That is, express only the viral dsRNA. And then these types of infected cell does not stimulate the host immune response, and they suggest that this infected cell express only viral dsRNA is a hallmark of the pulse virus persistent cells. The next question is there is the gene expression pattern related to the infected cell expressing only double-stranded RNA. So unfortunately, the general bulk RNA sequencing is limited to the dissect these three kinds of cell populations. So we applied the single-cell RNA sequencing method to find the hallmark of the pulse virus persistence. Objective of this study is to identify transcriptional signatures associated with this pulse persistence. For that, we prepare the non-infected cell as a control, and then the pulse persistently infected cells. And these two cell lines are sequenced by the chromium single cell 3' mRNA sequencing method. The gene expression of about 10,000 cells per each cell lines were quantified by the single-cell RNA sequencing, and in the integrity analysis between these two, all of these cells, we got the 11 clusters for the cells, shown in these right side figures. If we plot these cell clusters by treatment, we can find the distinct cluster in the pulse virus persistent cell lines. So we suspect that this cluster 3 is for the infected cells, and other cell types are for the non-infected cell based on the comparison between the control cell line and persistent cell lines. This bar plot clearly shows that in cluster 3, less than 2% of cells are exist in the control cell line, but more than 25% of cells are occupied in the pulse virus persistent cell line. So So we did the differentially expressed gene analysis between control and pulse virus poison cell lines. And then we found six genes, six DGs, and among them, several genes show this kind of unique expression patterns. They are highly expressed in the gene cell cluster 3. So we try to zoom in the pulse virus poison cell line to compare cluster 3 and other clusters. And the left side figures clearly show that the GPS2 gene and TUSC5 genes are highly expressed only in the cluster 3 compared to others. That means they support that the cluster 3 is an impacted cell distinguished with other clusters. We need to dissect this cluster 3 into the cells, infected cell expressing only the double stranded RNA and the infected cells expressing both protein and viral protein and RNAs. So we make the cluster focus on this cluster 3. And then I got the three different subcluster from the cluster 3 within the pulse poison cell line. Here, you can see in here, A and C cluster show the similar expression patterns compared to cluster B. So among these DGs, we focus on the GPS2 genes. This gene encodes the signal repressor in the signal cascade related to the immune gene expression. And then overexpression of GPS2 genes could suppress the host immune responses. So increase of these genes can be related to the ability, the feature that shown in the Purkinson cell line. The infected cell expressing only viral double-stranded RNA does not stimulate the host immune response. So this GPS2 gene can be a gene signature for that kind of mechanisms. Based on these gene's functions, we suspected that subcluster A and C in the cluster 3 of Purkinson cell line as infected cells expressing only viral double-stranded RNA. And the other cluster B suspected as an infected cell expressing both viral DNA, viral double-stranded RNA and the proteins. In summary, we've identified a distinct cluster in the pulse virus poison cell line, and we suspect that this cluster is for the infected cells among the whole Purkinson cell line. In further analysis, revealed that three small subclusters, and then cluster A and C show the increase of the GPS2 gene, GPS2 and TUSC5. So based on the GPS gene's function, we thought that cluster C is A and C could comprise cells that contain only the viral dsRNA. And this will be a feature of the pulse virus persistence mechanisms. So in conclusion, our studies have established a pulse virus persistence cell model system and also demonstrated the feasibility of using the single-cell RNA sequencing technology to identify the transcriptomic signatures of pulse virus persistence. I want to say thank you to Dr. Ying Fang. She was at the K-State, and recently she moved to the University of Illinois. She gave me an opportunity to involve in this project. And I also thanks to Dr. Mark Baker and Dr. Haibo Liu for their technical support for the single-cell sequencing, single-cell RNA sequencing. Thank you for your attention, and I might be happy to answer your questions.
Questions?
So with the genes that were differentially regulated, have you looked to see if they actually associate with viral proteins to maybe suppress transcription and translation? Because I saw that you had looked at immune genes and the relationship between your identified locus and...
We didn't check about that, but we will validate this result in the experimental things to the relationship between this increase of this gene and the actual repress of the immune response in the cell cell in the cells. Yeah.
I may miss your presentation, but with this technology, you should be able to find the viral RNA in the infected cell, right? Have you mapped the viral RNA into like the genome of the virus to see where it binds to and what transcript of viral viral transcript you can pick up from the cell, infected cell?
In this analysis, it's based on just the host gene expressions. So I didn't map to the PRRS virus genome in the PRRS virus lead to the reference genome. So if we integrate, if we tested the integrated analysis between the PRRS genome and this targeting the reference genome, we can find, I think we can find a more clue for the viral DNA, viral RNA for each, some specific cell types. Yes. So first time I integrated the cells from the non-infected cell and the persistently infected cells. To the reason why I integrate these two is to specify the non-infected cell groups and the infected cell group first. And then we dissect and focus on the infected cell cluster to define which cells are expressed only the viral RNAs. Okay, thank you.